In last week's video, in the Luoyang Museum, I show you the relics from the Heluo civilization in the Yellow River region, which was the foundation of Chinese civilization. The Yellow River is our proud, but it's also our sorrow. In today's video, I'll show you how much the Yellow River Delta has changed in only 30 years period through a collection of NASA photos. I'll also tell you how the floods of the Yellow River have formed the Chinese society.
Hello, I'm Yan Yan. I'm in Dongying, Shandong province. This is where the Yellow River meets the sea. River deltas quite often associated with metropolitans. For example, in Yangtze River Delta, we have Shanghai. In Pearl River Delta, we have Guangzhou. But I'm sure it's the first time for most of you to hear about Dongying. Why is that there's no metropolitan in Yellow River Delta? Today, I'll tell you the story about the Yellow River.
The Yellow River is the sixth longest river in the world, originating in the mountains in Qinghai province of the western China. It flows through 9 provinces. The Yellow River area was the cradle of ancient Chinese civilization, and it was the most prosperous region in early Chinese history. That's why in China, we call the Yellow River Mother River. Let's board the cruise ship to see the epic view of the Yellow River going into the sea. There is a very clear line dividing the water into blue and yellow part. It's more epic if you take the helicopter in the park and see it from the sky. The yellow water is not pollution. It's because the Yellow River is the most sediment-filled river on Earth. Each year, millions of tons of soil are carried away by the water. Some of the soil reaches the river's mouth. The estuaries are the result of this process. When the soil reaches the river's mouth, it builds and rebuilds the delta. If you're a bird lover, this is a good place to watch birds. Other than that, the park does not have much else to see. There is only one building by the pier where tourists could take a rest before or after taking a cruise ship. Before 1979, the mouth of the Yellow River was not in this place. It was in the city, but to the north of the current estuaries. In 1979, the government started a project to engineer the Yellow River to flow into the sea from here. Let's take a look at the coastal change since 1979 through a collection of NASA photos. This 1979 NASA image shows a rounded delta front. It's when the project just started. 10 years later, a protruding peninsula has formed at the mouth of the river. Between 1989 and 1995, the delta became longer and more narrow along a southeast bending arc. In 1996, a new channel was cut near the tip of the delta and forced the river to veer northeast. I don't know the reason behind that, but in the 1999 NASA image, we could clearly see that a new peninsula had formed to the north. The 2004 image shows that the new peninsula thickened in the next 5-year interval. By 2009, the shoreline northwest of the new river mouth settled and thickened considerably. That's the last image I could find in NASA's website. Let's compare the 1979 photo with the 2009 photo. The coastline changed from a smooth round to a shape that looks like a bird's beak. That's how much the delta has expanded in 30 years. And that's also how the estuaries we are visiting today have been formed. In the future, the newly formed peninsula will keep growing and might finally meet the Liaodong Peninsula in the northeast China. Then the Bohai Sea would become a lake in China. Well, that's just my imagination. See the oil dredger not far away? The Yellow River Delta is the second largest oil field in China. The 2009 NASA photo also pointed out the oil field. In the city of Dongying, you can find these oil dredgers everywhere. next to the road, below the office buildings, or even in a kindergarten.
Dongying has the second largest oil field in China, so you can see a lot of dredgers here. But this one is very unique because there is a kindergarten nearby. They made the dredger a giraffe to entertain the kids.
A heavy sediment load results in the rise of riverbed. The lower reaches of the Yellow River is a suspended river, also known as the raised bed river. Its bed is more than 3 meters higher than the ground. To the inhabitants of Kaifeng, a city in Henan province, Yellow River is called a river suspended in the sky. The water level of the Yellow River is about 10 meters above the bottom of the Iron Pagoda, the landmark of the city.
Because of clogged channels, the Yellow River region was hit by floods frequently. Big floods even resulted in change of river course. This picture illustrates courses of the lower Yellow River for the past 2,500 years. It was wandered up and down several hundred kilometers of coastline from the Bohai Sea to the Yellow Sea. These have only covered the fundamental avulsions of the river. Historical records show that in the past 2,500 years, the river has undergone 1,593 minor changes, 26 major changes, and 6 fundamental changes in its course, each time a disaster to the inundated population. There were 2 fundamental avulsions of the Yellow River in the past 1,000 years. Before the Southern Song Dynasty of the 12th century, the Yellow River went into the Bohai Sea as it does today, but in different locations along the coastal line. In 1128, in order to stop the invasion of the Zhejiang-led Jin Empire, a Song general broke the levees of the Yellow River, which resulted in a huge flood. The flood delayed the Jin army a little, but didn't stop them. However, it caused the Yellow River to abandon its outlet into the Bohai Sea. It veered southward and took the outlet of the Huai River into the Yellow Sea. In the ensuing 600 years, the Yellow River flew through the orange line in this picture. The floods coming with the river was a nightmare for people living in the region south of the orange line, present-day northern Anhui and Jiangsu provinces. To make life worse, in the 3 dynasties of this avulsion, Beijing was the capital. In order to protect the Grand Canal through which food and other important goods were moved from southern China to Beijing, the imperial courts always ordered to strengthen the northern side of the levees so that floods would only inundate the land in the south. In 1855, after being the nightmare of the people living in northern Anhui and Jiangsu provinces for 600 years, the Yellow River changed course again. It took the channel of a river in Shandong province and started to follow the yellow line in this picture. This time, the victims were the people in the low-lying farmland in Shandong province. There were political battles in the court. Officials from Shandong province suggested to engineer the river back to the previous course, but was strongly opposed by the officials from the previous flood plain. I feel people living in the previous floodplain never wanted to see their mother river again. Bye, mother river.
So now you know why there's no metropolitan in Yellow River Delta. First, shortage of water means the mouth is not a good harbor. Secondly, the land suffers years of seawater intrusion. The soil becomes salinized and is not good for agriculture. Thirdly, this delta has a very short history. The Yellow River didn't come here until 1855.
In the estuaries park, there is an old channel of the Yellow River, which was the one in the NASA photo before the river was engineered northward. Because the Yellow River changes course frequently, there are numerous old channels of the Yellow River in Shandong, Anhui, and Jiangsu provinces. It will be fun to explore those ancient channels in the future. Just like fighting the nomadic people, fighting the floods of Yellow River has also been a theme of Chinese civilization for thousands of years. There is a famous tale in China about an ancient Chinese leader, the Grand Yu, fighting the floods.
More than 4,000 years ago, there was a major flood that allegedly continued for at least two generations, causing disastrous damage to ancient China. Yu's father was tasked with controlling the flooding. He spent more than 9 years building a series of dikes and dams along the riverbanks, but was ineffective. Yu, while working with his father, made a careful study of the river systems in order to learn why his father's great efforts had failed. He found a solution. Instead of directly damming the river's flow, Yu made a system of irrigation canals which relieved flood water into fields, as well as spending great efforts dredging the riverbeds. The dredging and irrigation was successful and allowed the ancient Chinese culture to flourish along the Yellow River.
Ever since Emperor Shi Huang of Qin Dynasty unified China in 221 BC, for most of time in this land, there has been a unified country and a centralized government. Some scholars believe it is result of fighting the floods of Yellow River, because in order to manage Yellow River, it is required collaborative efforts from different regions and concentrated inputs in terms of labors and other resources. So, in order to understand the Chinese civilization and the political system, you should first meet our wayward mother river, our pride and our sorrow, the Yellow River.
In next week's video, I'll travel to the Loess Plateau and will visit a bend in the Yellow River in the border of Shanxi and the Shanxi provinces. I'll tell you where the soil in the Yellow River is from. I'm Yan Yan. I upload a video every Saturday about sites of interest in China and histories and stories behind them. Subscribe to my channel. I'll see you next week in Qianqun Bend.